1, 2, 3, 4. Get up, get on up.
Never been with an Italian, eh?
Oh, you don't need a haircut? Is that what you're telling me? You just came here for a blowjob?
Okay.
Look at you. Look how good you look.
Huh. Oh my God. Karen. I'm going blind.
Well, I like it because I got the abs.
I think Rick was, as a child, I don't think he had enough attention. He was always in attention.
Are you kidding? I had tons.
We started working together back in, like, the 80s.
When hair was big and hard.
Rick is good.
Yeah, he's fun. Easy too.
After you work with him for a while, yeah, tune exactly. him out.
Yeah.
You need a haircut!
Who doesn't know Italian people that are like us? Like, this is how we are, right? We're loud.
Hey, Dave, look at this.
Like, well, there's over 100 of us that cut hair in my family, first cousins.
Basically, in our family, going back to my uncles and cousins, when we graduate junior high school, we go to hair school, not high school.
Went to school with our mother.
This is our mother, Laura.
The mother of these boys.
You color this hair and it'll smoothen out the porosity and your hair will feel much softer.
David is very easygoing. He's very particular, though.
Yeah, out of the boys, I'd probably say he's...
The most serious.
Definitely. Yeah, the business guy. Yeah.
What are you guys doing?
Giving her a hand job.
Her hand and I'm doing her head, I guess.
You know, David's a little difficult to work with sometimes. He's the youngest brother.
Dave, are you upset?
No, never am.
Always has something to say. And seeking lots of attention. No, you said that. I agree. Anyway.
No, I work my chair.
You
work
your chair. You work your chair, but you bark and yip at everybody.
Well, someone's got to be manager. Yeah, someone's got to be manager.
A chihuahua
I should manage myself. Thank you very much.
Yeah.
Nico.
Oh, he's hilarious.
Yeah,
he makes us laugh all day.
I don't look at it as going bald. I look at it as getting more head. All on how you look at things. I need to fill my belly.
He likes to spend a lot of time outside in his car.
Most times when you come here, Nico's not here, right? Never. She knows. He'll be gone for half of the day. You gotta go in the back lane and you gotta scratch lottery tickets or go to the casino and find them.
I smoke, I drink, and I go to the casino one night a week.
My eye!
Just go Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday.
I don't.
That's every day of the week.
Working with Nico is like wanting to rip my hair out strand by strand.
You want to throw another layer onto
the... Their wives work here.
Our wives work here.
So we spend a lot of time together, but it's sort of not together. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Because we're doing the coloring and they're doing the cutting.
They're not my wife.
No, no. If his wife worked here, he'd be single.
He'd be divorced.
Oh, no, he wouldn't.
Oh, yeah. What are you going to do, Dave?
I'm going to give him a little flash.
Oh, my God. Let me do the other side.
Oh, go ahead.
Okay.
We don't get along. Who gets along here? He knows everything, so I can't argue with the guy, so I don't talk to the guy. No, I'm gonna fix all this now with the clippers.
I will. Get me the clippers.
See how controlling he is?
We don't keep things bottled up, or eventually you have a nervous breakdown and you can't stand people and don't talk to them anymore.
And I think our clients like that because they think that, well, maybe my life's not so great. They come here and hear us fighting and this and that. They feel excellent. It's like we're not the only people.
But it's not always fighting.
Did I sound like I was finished?
It's not a really cookie-cutter salon like other places. It's very different.
Come and grab Tracy's tits.
Tracy, I would never do that.
You've done it.
I've never grabbed
a
woman.
I've seen you.
Never.
We tell our clients if you're referring somebody here, please warn them.
Okay, check this out.
Okay, this is good.
This is what happens. Your father is rich. You got too much money. Instead of cutting yourself, you do your hair purple and wear ugly makeup. It works for her. You know, that works, going ugly. What a terrible thing to say to somebody. We do a lot of people that live rurally. We do a lot of people from Medicine Hat, Red Deer, Rosebud, Caroline, places you haven't even heard of. We actually want to get a bus. You know Priscilla, Queen of the Desert? A big bus like that. Miko could stand on the roof holding the chiffon.
With my hair flowing.
And we want to put in 3 hair chairs. And we want to take us on the road.
Get them out of a salon and meeting people.
And give us a break.
Oh, yeah, and we get a nice break, too, if we're not with them or
if they're on the road.
Yeah.
Do their hair. Make over Edna. You know, the lady wears her husband's socks. Put the Quebec in 5-minute sign, and instead of going in the back with Earl, come into the bus with us. I'm the mediator. You got to agree.
Yeah, Rick's a good mediator. His way's always right.
Yes.
Doesn't that work?
Everybody else is wrong.
Oh, no, suddenly I'm the control freak in the couch.
Well, you're both kind of control freaks if you really want
to know. I listen to you. You're not here. How would you know?
I just sit back.
Oh, yeah, you
let
sit
it roll off.
Actually, I would love you after this to talk to the staff.